I was just at the right place at the right time.
Only on WLWT, a humble hero tonight, a local school bus driver, is being credited with saving a student's life.
The route home from school quickly turning into a rescue mission in Monroe.
And that's where we find tonight WLWT News Vice Karen Johnson. Karen, this driver knew something was wrong from the moment this student stepped on the bus, right?
That's right, Cherie. School had just let out. Usually kids will hop on the school bus, handing out high fives and hugs. But the end of the day excitement quickly turned to panic. But not for one bus driver who remained calm and let her training take over.
So it was just a normal afternoon.
Toni Paugh all buckled in, ready to begin her last run of the day. The Peterman bus driver was sitting outside of Monroe Primary School as the first graders were piling on the bus.
You just have to pay attention to everything. You just have to know your surroundings. You have to know your kids. Look them in the eyes. Greet them, you know, give them a smile.
So when 7-year-old Landon Hogan, who is normally talkative, walked on without saying a word, Toni knew something was wrong.
He had his mouth open and he wasn't talking at all. And I said, Landon, are you okay? And he shook his head no, looked down, then he put his hands, placed his hands on his throat.
I choked on a hard candy when I got on the bus.
And the first grader wasn't breathing. Toni's first aid training kicked in. She began performing the Heimlich maneuver on him.
I did 2 pumps. Nothing happened. I took a look at him. He still was unable to breathe.
Toni carried Landon off the bus and onto the sidewalk.
So I did 2 more chest pumps, and the candy came flying out of his mouth.
She helped me get it out, then I went to the nurse.
Toni says she was just doing her job, and her company and the firefighters who trained her are the ones who should be credited with saving Landon's life.
So in this, it's going to be Peterman and the Monroe firefighters, the hero, not me. I was just at the right place at the right time.
And one thing I did learn today, all Peterman bus drivers, no matter what district they're assigned to, are required to take first aid training. Reporting live tonight in Monroe, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.
Oh, so glad.